Water, H2O, equals life. It's a simple equation, yet it took over 2 years for the American Museum of Natural History to research, write, and present the most comprehensive exhibition about water to date. Many of us take it for granted, yet in its fresh and salty form, it is the backdrop to our very existence. But for visitors, this is much more than just a dynamic three-dimensional display of artifacts and information panels. It is a thought-provoking journey of discovery and education, a place to ponder questions and wonder if we could perhaps be better stewards of our global water supply.
When you first walk into the exhibit, the first thing you see is this beautiful fog screen. And you hear behind you sounds of water, so that there's a sense of abundance of water. But once you walk through the fog screen, you walk into an area where the room is quite dark, and the only lit thing in the room is a single drop of water that falls from the ceiling. And the purpose of that is to help people to understand that while water does surround us everywhere, and at the local scale it's a renewable resource, at the global scale it's finite. We have all the water we will ever have.
Life in Water is the introductory section of the exhibit.
We try to feature the different adaptations that animals and plants around the world have to a variety of kinds of water and quantities of waters, thinking about how it's distributed, the fact that 97% of the Earth's water is salty water, and very little fresh water is available to humans and other species that depend on fresh water for their survival.
The second section is Blue Planet, and looks at water from a global perspective. Where did it all come from? And how long ago?
Water is the only substance on Earth that's found at normal temperature and pressure in liquid, solid, and vapor form. We designed a sculpture so that people could touch the water in its three phases.
The Waterworks section examines how water shapes the Earth, and a 10-foot-tall canyon forms the entrance to it. Once out the other side, visitors see some startling facts about human consumption of H2O.
People all around the world use water in a number of different ways. For instance, in the United States, we use 150 gallons of water a day. In the United Kingdom, people use closer to 30 gallons a day. And in Africa, people only have access to about 3 gallons of water a day.
The next two sections explore how water is distributed unevenly across the Earth. First, water everywhere.
In this section, we explore some of the wettest places on Earth, some of the iciest places on Earth, and how different species, including humans, are able to survive in these areas.
Then comes the opposite scenario, not a drop.
We talk about the areas of the world where very little water is available to humans and other species that depend on fresh water.
The Healthy Water section features a high-powered microscope, which visitors love to use, and is a vivid example of why looking at water close up is important. There's an interactive scale model of a play pump device as well, which provides a look at one of the many innovative technologies being used to give people access to water.
In this section, we have an interactive exhibit where you can visit various cities from around the world, and you can see the actual infrastructure it takes to bring water to those cities. And you also see what it takes to clean the water after it's left people's drains.
The final part of the exhibit is all about restoring ecosystems and provides examples of how humans are rethinking their attitude towards the aquatic environment on Earth.
The visitor is immersed in a diorama. They're walking through the middle of the diorama of tufa towers from Mono Lake, California. And these towers were exposed when Mono Lake level fell drastically as water was diverted from the lake system. As this exhibit travels around the world, we'll feature local heroes from those areas so that people can be inspired by people in their community making a difference.
Water H2O equals life has been an immensely popular exhibition. The American Museum of Natural History chose a subject matter that is truly universal in its appeal, which explains its popularity with visitors of all ages. To young people, it is a three-dimensional interactive wonderland. To adults, it presents the facts in a vivid and thought-provoking way. It is an exhibition that no one can ignore and no one should miss.
And it's been very exciting in the exhibit to see people talking about the issues, not just of having fun or playing with the interactive, but really grappling with this, the idea that We need to change our behavior. We need to change our ethics about water. And sharing those ideas and information with each other is one way we can help to ensure people will follow through with action.